Hello, good day to everyone. Welcome to this session of Customer's Testimonial for Track 1, Modern Data Platform. Today, my name is Sukumaran. I'm the Vice President for the Systems Consulting Hybrid Cloud Systems, Asia Pacific for the Cloud Systems Group in Oracle. When we looked at CRIF-iMark, a very interesting customer that have gone through a whole accelerated journey. And today, we are fortunate to have the CIO himself, Mr. Pinkesh. Pinkesh has been in this CIO role for the last 17 years. Pinkesh, welcome to this section on a customer testimonial and what are the things that you have done for the organization. Give us a context about what is CRIF all about and what do you guys do for a living? I think that'll be interesting for most of them.
Sure, Soku. So CRIF in India is an RBI regulated entity, which is a credit bureau in India. We are providing services to all the banks, NBFCs and telecom services with the business information and credit information. We provide analytical solutions as well. We are the only full service bureau in India. We are having customers all around the world with 6,300 banks, 55,000 corporate clients and 310K consumers who are using us in around 50 countries on daily basis. We are having 4,600 plus members, 1.6 billion records of individuals and 38 plus billions million records of non-individuals in our database. We are only bureau who is providing combination of CIR as well within India.
Wonderful. You know, Pinkesh, when you were talking about the business growth, you had a couple of key business drivers that you're looking at from the context of how you're going to drive the business forward. Can you share with the audience what are some of this business growth you had in mind?
Definitely, Suku. So in India, you know that the credit industry is growing a lot from last 6 years. We are having a lot of fintechs players who are coming into the market. We are having a lot of new products which are coming into the market. For example, buy now, pay later, consumer durables, personal loans, salary day, payday. Those kind of products are coming also. And with this COVID situation, people are going more and more digital. So overall, the credit industry in India is growing a lot, and that for every credit, before approving the credit, they have to verify the credit worthiness of the person with the bureaus, and that's where our main bread and butter or business is. With that, definitely, with this kind of business growth, we have to be leading in the business. We have to provide a real desired performance to our customers, because this millennials who are coming on this digital platform stay very few seconds. So from lending till underwriting and dispersal, we have to do underwriting in like few milliseconds. During peak, we have to be ready with the peak time, because in India the overall credit industry is at a peak, right? So we have to provide capacity to process those kind of volume during the peak time. So we have to be ready with that. We have to be responsive in the response times as well. We need to provide the guarantee of 99.5 to 99.9 uptime. And we need to be agile in terms of the kind of technology which we are using, because all the fintechs who are coming in the market are using the latest technology in terms of for example, the integration is not happening with XML anymore. It is just like JSON they are using, or machine learning or AI ML, those kind of technology which they are using. So we have to be very, very flexible in using the latest technology, adopting the latest technology as well, Subhu, I would say.
And I think, Pinkesh, for the longest time, you have always been making this statement, which I have been using it across many countries, right? Generic infrastructure delivers generic results. Can you shed some color into why you made this statement in some of our previous engagements?
So, definitely. So you know that, with previously what you used to do is, if you used to have 8 core CPU, we used to run 8 threads, but now it's not the case. We want to have parallelism, multi-threading as well. So, with substandard performance we get with the generic infrastructure, inefficient resources, because of the, if you want to process more and more volume, you need to add more and more infrastructure. So, that was the standard thing which we used to say with the generic infrastructure. no guaranteed, no integrated security, because security solution come as a separate solution which you have to install on this generic infrastructure. Greater efforts in operations because of the patching. You need to patch server separately, you need to patch storage separately, you need to patch network separately. If you want to move to cloud, again, you need to be compatible with different, for example, you know, there are so many cloud providers available in the market. They may have a different solution. So your solution needs to be compatible with that as well. So, you know, overall, generic infrastructure doesn't give the flexibility, the kind of we need for our business growth, which I've already mentioned the parameters like performance, peak time, response time, uptime, and latest technology, which is not possible with the generic infrastructure. So those, that's why, you know, I say that generic infrastructure delivers generic results, but we cannot continue with that anymore, Subbu.
Interesting. I think, you know, Pinkesh, what you have outlined with in this contents here is that it's a combination of performance, which is critical for business viability and growth, security, which is non-negotiable, operational excellence, which you need to drive this kind of highly competitive business, and more importantly, is the cloud assurance you're looking at, whether I'm going to run on-premise or on a cloud environment. You want to have that level of product identicality, which I think is good. Pinkesh, I know you started sometime in 2013 with some generic servers, and you were looking at an integrated platform like Exadata. Can you take us through your whole Exadata platform journey, how it came about, and what are some of the interesting lessons you learned from that?
Sure, Subbu. So if you know that just now I was talking about generic infrastructure, and we started with the traditional architecture, which everybody used to use database as a, you know, install on a server, then there'll be a storage which connect to SAN storage. So we started with that. It was good for initial years, but you know, the way the growth was happening, we wanted a new solution which can deliver performance, uptime, and security as well. And that's where we moved from, you know, multi-vendor strategy to Exadata. We evaluated the POC we have done and the kind of you know, performance we needed. We moved in 2013 to Exadata X4 Ethrac. We were able to deliver the response time from few minutes to few milliseconds to our customer. We continued with that. We added two extra storage cells as well during that journey, because we were getting the regular performance as well, and our business was growing as well. After that, from in 2018, Subbu, we moved to Exadata X7, where our business has actually grown a lot, and also the Indian market has grown a lot. The benefit of ExaCC X7 was that, you know, we wanted a solution where, you know, we can scale up. So there was only two solutions. Either we have one more Exadata and we process it, or we take a solution, because during the peak time, we wanted some extra CPUs to process our volumes. So we went with Exadata CC, which has the flexibility to scale up, because it is similar to cloud without being on the cloud. So you have your, it's like in your private cloud. And because of the RBI regulation, we cannot move to the cloud directly. So that's why we moved to X7 in 2018, where we are getting the similar kind of performance. Even the migration was, you know, seamless, because from it was an Exadata X4 to X7. So migration was easy as well. And because of this, we were not having similar kind of performance in DR till now, because, you know, in DR also we need to have another Exadata. But with Exadata CS coming into India, we actually went live in 2020 with Exadata CS also in DR. So now our data is getting synced up on real time as well. We are getting all the performance in DR as well as on the ExaCC as well, similar kind of performance. And it is very cost effective, because you don't have to worry about the license cost and everything. It is a bundle into it, and you don't have to pay upfront. It is like, you know, OPEX model, and you can increase the CPU as and when you need it. So overall, you know, we are able to achieve what we wanted to for our business growth, Subbu, with this.
You know, Pinkesh, when we look at the overall benefits, right, I think you are using the different parts of the Exa platform. Can you just share with the larger audience, what are some of the benefits that you gained through this platform deployment?
So one of the so I'll start with the moving from one to another Exadata X4 to X7 and to DR customized service. So it was very simple migration. I would say that Oracle has made sure that the backward compatibility is there. It's easy to, for us to migrate from one X4 to X7 and then from X7 to X7 on DR side as well. So no, we don't have to worry about the migration part at all. Overall capacity wise, what we have done is with X7, you can tell, okay, I might need X number of CPU during the peak time, but on my regular basis, I will need only X minus something, right? So in that way, I am covered that without going to cloud, I can have the flexibility of the cloud. I don't have to worry about the bundled of the softwares. Okay, all the softwares are part of the X7. So I don't have to pick and choose. I need this software or that software or that software. Or everything is available bundled in the X7. So I don't have to pay anything extra for different softwares. Whatever I need in terms of security and everything is taken care in that. In terms of availability, right? Uptime, Oracle guarantees 99.9 because it is completely managed by Oracle. So patching, security, everything is managed by Oracle. I don't have to worry about any audit from RBI or anyone because my security and patching is happened on quarterly basis. So, I'm taken care by that as well. I don't have to worry about, whether, this has been done or not. In terms of overall, this contract is signed for 4 years, right? So, which means that if there is any upgrade comes, I don't have to worry about a new upgrade of the EXA CC as well. Because whenever the new upgrade comes, and if I require that, Oracle can come and, they can upgrade and replace it as well. So, I don't have to worry about, my overall worry about the uptime, about security patches, about the software cost, about scale up of the infrastructure, latest technology, everything has been taken care of by Oracle. I just have to run the business. So that's the main advantage I would see with the EXA Cloud at customer, Subbu, I would say that.
Pinkish, I'm in tears now, as you can see, right? Tears of joy. They're listening to the benefits that you have derived from this deployment. I think it really talks about the whole simplicity, the agility, the elasticity. More importantly, right, it appears to me that it has a very deep impact on your business transformation. And I think that's really something very heartwarming to understand. Because just, I know you're a busy executive, right? For the audience listening in, right, what will be some of your key takeaway messages? Because I think that is something which is very important, critical for all of us listening in.
I would say that, to all my colleagues, CIO colleagues, that, if you're looking for a solution to grow your business, you want a reliable solution from the uptime point of view, you don't want to worry about the outflow of your money, you don't want to invest upfront in the licensing cost, hardware cost, I think EXA CC is the best solution because of the performance it provides. You don't have to worry about your IOPS. The scalability it provides, because whenever you need more and more CPU to process more and more volumes, you can anytime scale up. About your patching, something can go wrong because it is not patched completely, or there's some bug in the patching or security point of view. You can just click on one button and the patching is done. Security is taken care of because it's an Oracle solution. They really understand their solution well, and security is inbuilt within their solution. Regular security patches also come whenever there is a new ransomware in the market. You will get a new security patch as well, which comes along with it. Data sovereignty is already taken care in that. You don't have to worry about where your data is, in which region and all. And this can be your first step, because if you are afraid of moving your solution to cloud, you can experience how it is going to work in cloud at your own premises. And that can be your journey to move to the cloud as well. So, if you see, and complete cost is in OPEX model, so you don't have to do any upfront investment for anything. And you don't have to, plan things that, what software you will need later on, because everything comes bundled here. So I would say that, that's a single solution, and you take away, 4 to 5 items from your regular checklist, I would say that.
What you have demonstrated, Pinkish, is something which is, I guess, is an eye-opener for many customers who are listening in. And again, Pinkish, thanks for your time today. I think you have shared with us some very interesting golden nuggets about the company itself, the challenges that they've gone through, the EXA platform journey that you have undertaken. But more importantly, all this has to lead, the outcome is in terms of the benefits, and I think you have benefited well. So again, thanks guys for everything.